everyone, welcome to business statistics class. So in today's video we will study about random variable and some of the problems related to it. So now we know when two fair coins are tossed, the sample space was capital TT, which represents we will get tail in both the coins when we toss, and the next sample point would be TH, which is we will get tail in the first coin and head in the second coin, and then the next sample point was HT, which is head in the first coin and tail in the second coin, and HH, which represents head appears in both the coins. So suppose to each of the four sample points in the sample space a number is assigned as follows. So these are the sample points, and for this the number is assigned as 0, 1, 1, 2. So here the number assigned indicate the number of heads obtained in each case. So here there is no head, therefore the number assigned is 0, and here there is one head, therefore the number is 1, and similarly there is one head, so number is 1, and there are two heads, therefore the number is 2. So let the number of heads be denoted by capital X, then X is the function on the sample space. So it takes values 0, 1 and 2 with the probability X is equal to 0, that is probability of getting no heads is 1 by 4. Because we have one sample point where the number 0 is assigned, that is no heads appear. So its probability is 1 by 4. And then probability of X is equal to 1, that is probability of getting one head is 1 by 2. So there are two outcomes where the probability of getting head is 2, therefore 2 by 4, which is 1 by 2. And then probability of getting two heads is again 1 by 4, because there is one favorable outcome. For X is equal to 2, the probability is 1 by 4. So here X is called the random variable or variate. So now let us see the definition of random variable. So it is also represented as R dot V. So random variable is a function which assigns a real number to every sample point in the sample space. So the set of such real values is the range of the random variable. So here we can see the range is from 0 to 2 when we toss a fair coin, two fair coins are tossed. So there are two types of random variables, namely discrete random variable and continuous random variable. So a variable X which takes x1, x2 up to so on till xn with probabilities small p1, p2 up to so on till pn is a discrete random variable. Here the values x1, x2 up to so on till xn form the range of the random variables. So a random variable whose range is uncountably infinite is called as a continuous random variable. So example 1 states, let X denote the number of heads obtained while tossing two fair coins. Then X is a random variable which takes the value 0, 1 and 2 with respective probabilities we had seen 1 by 4, 1 by 2 and 1 by 4. So here X is a discrete random variable. In the second example, let X denote the number obtained while throwing a fair die. Then X is a discrete random variable taking values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 with probability 1 by 6 each. So we had seen such examples in the previous classes of probabilities. So when you throw a die, probability of getting any one number is 1/6. So similarly, for all the individual numbers, the probability would be 1/6. Therefore, x is a discrete random variable where x denotes the number obtained while throwing a fair die. The third example is, let x denote the weight of apples. So then x is a continuous random variable. So this is an uncountably infinite continuous random variable. So generally, random variables are denoted by capital alphabets x, y, z, etc. If x is a random variable, the values taken by x are denoted by small x. So the next important definition is probability mass function, which is abbreviated as PMF, probability function. So let x be a discrete random variable and let p of x be a function such that p of x is equal to p of capital X is equal to small x, that is probability of the random variable x is equal to small x. Then p of x is the probability mass function of discrete random variable capital X. So here p of x is greater than or equal to 0 for all x, and summation of p of x is 1. A similar function is defined for a continuous random variable capital X, and it is called as probability density function, that is PDF, and it is denoted by small f of x. So for discrete random variable, we can define probability mass function, whereas for continuous random variable, we define probability density function, and probability mass function is denoted by small p of x, and probability density function is denoted by small f of x. So probability mass function is nothing but p of x is equal to probability of x is equal to small x. So a systematic representation of the values taken by a random variable and corresponding probabilities is called probability distribution of the random variable. So now let us see the mathematical expectation. So the mathematical expectation of random variable, let x be a discrete random variable with probability mass function p of x, then the mathematical expectation of x is expectation of x is equal to summation of small x into p of x. So this is expectation of x. So for a given discrete random variable capital X, when you take the expectation, the formula is summation x into p of x, where p of x is the probability mass function. So mathematical expectation of a function h of x. So let x be a discrete random variable with probability mass function p of x, then the mathematical expectation of any function h of x is, that is expectation of h of x is equal to summation h of x into respective probability mass function, which is p of x. So we will understand this better by solving problems. So the first problem is, two fair coins are tossed once. Find the mathematical expectation of the number of heads obtained. So here, let us denote capital X as the number of heads obtained. Then x is a random variable which takes the values 0, 1 and 2 with respective probabilities 1 by 4, 1 by 2 and 1 by 4. That is, so here the small x range is 0, 1 and 2. So 0 represents that there are no heads, and 1 represents when you toss two fair coins, there are single head obtained, and this represents two heads are obtained. So the respective probabilities, we know how to calculate probabilities. Therefore, the probability of getting zero head is 1/4. That is, in sample space we have one outcome, which is T and T, that is there are no heads in this. Therefore, the probability is 1/4. So similarly, when x is 1, p of x is 1/2, and 2, when x is 2, the p of x is 1/4. Therefore, the mathematical expectation of the number of heads is, we know expectation of x is equal to summation x into p of x. So we know the values of x, we know the values of px. So multiply individually and then take the summation sign. That is 0 into 1/4 plus 1 into 1/2 plus 2 into 1/4. So therefore, expectation of x is 1. So there are two important results. That is, for a random variable x, the arithmetic mean is expectation of x. For a random variable x, the variance is, so it is denoted by variance of x, which is expectation of x minus e of x whole square, or we can rewrite it as expectation of x square minus expectation of x the whole square. And the standard deviation is the square root of the variance. So we had seen these properties in the third unit. That is, the square of standard deviation is variance. So the reverse is, the standard deviation is the square root of the variance. So this is the arithmetic mean, which is expectation of x, and the formula for calculating variance of x is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So let us see some examples. So for the following probability distribution, find expectation of x, variance of x, standard deviation of x, and expectation of 2x minus 4. So they have given x and p of x. So the x value ranges from minus 1 to 2, and the respective probability mass functions are given. So now, for expectation of x, we require, the formula is x, summation of x into p of x. So we require x and p of x, which is already given. And then for variance, we require x square value. So we have to calculate the square of this, that is x square. And then they have asked another question, which is 2x minus 4. So in another table, we have to find out the value of 2x minus 4. So now let us form another table. So the various values x, x square, and 2x minus 4 along with the given probabilities are, so this is x, which is already given, and this is the corresponding probabilities values, which is 1/5, 1/10, 3/10, and 2/5. So now let us calculate x square. So minus 1 square is again 1. So 0 square is 0, 1 square is 1, and 2 square is 4. So next let us calculate 2x minus 4. So 2 into minus 1 minus 4, which is minus 2 minus 4, which is minus 6. So we got minus 6. So similarly, calculate for all the values of small x, that is 2 into 0 minus 4, so it is minus 4, then 2 minus 4 is minus 2, and then 4 minus 4 is 0. So we have got the values of x, x square, 2x minus 4 along with the probabilities. So now let us calculate expectation of x. So expectation of x is summation x into p of x. So first x is minus 1 into respective probability, that is 1 by 5 plus 0 into 1 by 10 plus 1 into 3 by 10 plus 2 into 2 by 5, then simplify. Therefore, expectation of x value is 0.9. Similarly, the formula for expectation of x square is, so here in place of x we have x square. So here in place of x we will be having x square. Therefore, we have the table for x square. Therefore, expectation of x square would be 1 into its respective probability, which is 1 by 5 plus 0 into 1 by 10 plus 1 into 3 by 10 plus 4 into 2 by 5. When we simplify, we will get expectation of x square as 2.1. So now we have the value of expectation of x and expectation of x square. Let us calculate the variance of x. So we know the formula of variance as expectation of x square minus expectation of x the whole square. So expectation of x square, we got it as 2.1, and expectation of x value is 0.9. We have to take the square of it. Therefore, variance of x is 2.1 minus 0.9 whole square, which is 1.29. And similarly, standard deviation of x is square root of variance of x. We got variance as 1.29. So the square root of 1.29 is 1.136. So this is the standard deviation. And next they have asked to find out expectation of 2x minus 4. So in place of x we have 2x minus 4. Therefore the formula is summation 2x minus 4 into its respective probability. So we got the values of 2x minus 4. Therefore, minus 6 into 1 by 5 plus minus 4 into 1 by 10 plus minus 2 into 3 by 10 and then 0 into 2 by 5. So when we simplify, we get the answer as minus 2.2. So this is how we can find out the values of arithmetic mean and variance, standard deviation, or for any given question. So this variance and the variance which we had seen in the third unit are same, but here we are taking expectation. So the third question is, for the following probability distribution, find expectation of x, expectation of 2x minus 4, expectation of x square plus 2, variance of x and standard deviation of x. So they have given the values of x and their respective probabilities. So x ranges from minus 2 to plus 2 and their respective p of x are given. So first, let us find expectation of x, which is summation x into p of x. We have the values of x, we have the values of p of x. Multiply and then take the summation. So that is minus 2 into 0.2 plus 0 into 0.4 plus 1 into 0.3 plus 2 into 0.1. So when we simplify, we will get expectation of x as 0.1. So next, let us find out expectation of 2x minus 4. So 2x minus 4 would be, put x values in this term, that is 2 into minus 2, that is minus 4, and then minus 4, which is minus 8. So similarly, 2 into 0, that is 0, so we got minus 4, and then substitute x value in this. So 2 into 1, that is 2, and then minus 4, we got the answer as minus 2. Then 2 2's are 4, 4 minus 4 is 0. So therefore, expectation of 2x minus 4 is summation of 2x minus 4 into their respective p of x. So minus 8 into 0.2 plus minus 4 into 0.4 plus minus 2 into 0.3 plus 0. Therefore, when we simplify, we will get the answer as minus 3.8. So, even you guys try to work out these problems. So, next let us find out variance of x. So, in variance of x, we have to calculate x square. Therefore, first let us find out the values of x square. That is, minus 2 square is 4. 0 square is again 0, 1 square is 1 and 2 square is 4. So we got the values of x square. Let us find out expectation of x square. So multiply and then take the summation, that is 4 into 0.2 plus 0 into 0.4 plus 1 into 0.3 plus 4 into 0.1. Therefore expectation of x square is 1.5. So now we got expectation of x value and expectation of x square value. Therefore variance of x would be expectation of x square minus expectation of x the whole square. So 1.5 minus 0.1 whole square, which is 1.49. Then if we'll take the square root of variance, then we will get the value of standard deviation, which is 1.22. And next, let us find out expectation of x square plus 2. So expectation of x square plus 2 is summation x square plus 2 into p of x. So we have x square value, so just add 2 to x square. Therefore x square plus 2 would be 4 plus 2, which is 6. So this is 2 and this is 2 plus 1, which is 3, and 4 plus 2, which is 6. So now we have x values for x square plus 2. So therefore expectation of x square plus 2 would be 6 into 0.2 plus 2 into 0.4 plus 3 into 0.3 plus 6 into 0.1. When we add, we get the expectation of x square plus 2 as 3.5. So the next example is, find the mean and variance of the number of points obtained in a throw of a fair die. So here let x denote the number of points obtained in the throw, then the probability distribution of x is, so when we throw a fair die, then we may get the outcome as the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So their respective probabilities is 1 by 6 for each small x value. So now they have asked to find out mean and variance. So mean is nothing but expectation of x, and variance is, we know variance of x as expectation of x square minus expectation of x the whole square. So by substituting in the formula, 1 into 1 by 6 plus 2 into 1 by 6 plus 3 into 1 by 6 plus 4 into 5 by 6 plus 5 into 1 by 6 and plus 6 into 6 by 6. When we simplify, we can take 1 by 6 common. So therefore 1 by 6 into 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to so on till 6. So which is 7 by 2, which is 3.5. Therefore the mean is 3.5. And then to get the variance, we need expectation of x square. So square each value of x and then multiply with your respective probabilities and then take the summation. Therefore expectation of x square would be 1 square into 1 by 6 plus 2 square into 2 by 6 up to 6 square into 1 by 6. So again we can take 1 by 6 common. So the remaining value would be 1 plus 4 plus 9 up to so on till 6 square, that is 36. So therefore expectation of x square is 91 by 6. So substitute these in the formula of variance of x. Therefore variance of x is equal to expectation of x square minus expectation of x the whole square. So 91 by 6 minus 7 by 2 whole square, which is 35 by 12. So we got the value of mean and variance of the number of points obtained in a throw of a fair die. So in probability, we used to just calculate the probabilities, whereas in random variables, we calculate mean, variance and other important properties assigned to a probability values. That is, a number is assigned to the sample points. So the fifth problem is, find the missing probability in the following distribution and then find expectation of x. So here the values of x are given, which ranges from 0 to 4, and the probabilities are 3 by 8, 1 by 4, and this value is missing. We have to find it out, and then 3 by 16 and 1 by 16. So we know that for any probability distribution, summation of p of x is equal to 1. That is, when you add these values, we have to get it as 1. Therefore, using this, we can find out the missing value. Therefore, 3 by 8 plus 1 by 4 plus, let this missing value be k. So k plus 3 by 16 plus 1 by 16 is equal to 1. So add these values, we will get k plus 14 by 16, and then solve for k. Therefore, k is 1 by 8. Then the probability distribution is x is from 0 to 4, and the respective probabilities are 3 by 8, 1 by 4, and we found the missing probability as 1 by 8. So substitute that. Now we got all the values of probabilities, then we can easily find out the expectation value. Therefore, expectation of x is summation x into p of x. So we got the x values and we got the respective probabilities, multiply and then take the summation. Therefore, the mean, that is expectation of x, is 21 by 16. So we can use the concept of random variables and then we can find out the missing probability in a given probability distribution. So that's it for today's class, and in the next video we will solve some more problems. Thank you.